Lightning Bolt.
Usain Bolt, prince of the track. Watch out, he is ready to attack.
Know your fault, that it happens so fast. Unless you're interested in that, who come last.
When the gun shoots in the air, Usain has no fear. England, Canada, USA, beware.
Hold on, think back, it's time to shine. Lightning Bolt strike twice in record time.
Usain Bolt streaking away from the field. It's going to be gold for Jamaica. That is superb. It's a new world record. He has blown them all away. That was phenomenal.
There is no doubt about it. Usain Bolt is unique. I mean, he is ridiculously unique. This country is a phenomena in itself. I mean, it's got a population of just under 3 million people, and it has amassed 13 gold medals in the Olympics. It's fair to say this place is a sprinting powerhouse. But what is it that makes Jamaicans so fast? Well, I'm here to find out. It's a story that involves some hard training.
Everyone here is focused, man. Look at them, focused.
A look back into history.
So Jamaica will rule for a long time to come.
I like this. Not that you're biased.
And some very special vegetables.
Get some of the good Jamaican yam. That will make him run faster.
We love winning, so we work hard because we're a very proud race. So we're just confident in what we do, always.
Record! He has blown them all away! That was phenomenal!
Grandstand ticket here, grandstand.
Yes, come over here and buy your beaches ticket. Right away, ticket office.
I've arrived just as the biggest event of the Jamaican sporting calendar is kicking off. It's called Champs, and it's the most immense school sports day imaginable.
Now, I don't know what your school sports day was like, but mine, well, it was pretty average. But here in Jamaica, they take school sports into another level.
Champs lasts for 4 days and is televised across the whole of Jamaica. More than 200 schools send their best sports stars to compete. Previous champions have gone on to win Olympic gold and break world records. And it's where Usain Bolt, the fastest man in the world, was first spotted.
Now the final quarter, Alvin Dixon of Calabar.
But Bolt isn't the only one. For years, Jamaicans have dominated the world of sprinting. But what makes them so good? Well, there are several theories.
We're at William Nibb Memorial High School. This is where the man himself, Usain Bolt, went to school. And in here, a group of athletes who are trying their best to be just like him, if not better.
I arrive as a group are putting in some last minute training for this year's champs.
I actually can't believe this is where Usain Bolt used to train. It's not so much an athletics track, but just dust. And in terms of William Nibb as a school, the confidence and discipline they're instilling in these children is just absolutely phenomenal. What I can't wait to see is who the next Usain Bolt's gonna be.
They're trying to improve on things. Bolt is funding the building of a new canteen. And also providing kit for the athletes. It's a gesture that hasn't gone unnoticed.
How does someone like Usain Bolt inspire you to be a better runner?
Well, a lot. He has inspired me a lot to see how his hard work has paid off for him in life and to see that he's doing back for the school and for everyone that, you know.
Would you like to one day be in the same
position? Yes, I'd like to be in his position one day to do work for my school and my family and my community and my country.
Achieving more is what the sports programs here are designed to do. Get these kids performing sport at the highest level, but also give them an option. Something to aspire to in a country where the average salary is a mere $400 a month, where poverty forces many into a life of crime. Lorna Thorpe is head of PE at William Nibb. She taught Bolt when he was at school here, and pupils today still see her as an inspiration.
How do you feel when I say to you, a lot of them credit their success to you? I've spoken to a few of them now, and they say, without her, we couldn't have got to where we got to. I mean, how does that make you feel as a person?
Well, very good, but it's part of my job. So I have to just work for them. That's what I get paid for, to work with them.
You're so modest, you're so modest. You guys are making such a massive difference here. Because, I mean, what would they be doing otherwise? They'd be out in the street or they'd be doing something
else
they shouldn't be doing, you know?
Exactly.
And you say it's a job, but I think it's a little more than that from what I see here.
It's a passion.
It is, it really
it's
is.
It's a passion, right?
You ask Usain,
he'll tell you that. If you ask Michael Green and Weber, it's just a passion. I have to be there for them. Say.
Each parish has a different type of yam.
Yams grow all over Jamaica, and many think they might have magical speed-giving properties. There's no specific evidence to prove this, but studies here are investigating the possible link between the yam and muscle growth. What is pretty clear, though, is that if you want a bit of a boost, a yam is a good food to give you that quick burst of energy.
I've been trying to figure out what makes Jamaicans so fast, and people are telling me that these yams are essential. I mean, I eat yams, and after I've eaten yams, I'm not going to lie to you, I feel a bit sleepy. So I don't know if it gives you energy. I mean, what's so special about them?
Well, maybe I've had too much, but really, these yams are complex carbohydrates. In other words, they are made up of special nutrients that release slowly in the bloodstream that give the players energy, or the athletes, energy over a longer time.
Right, I see.
Compare that to a simple biscuit, which just has flour and sugar and sweetening. This is a complex carbohydrate, whereas a biscuit is a simpler carbohydrate.
See,
that won't work as well.
Ska, ska, ska. Jamaica, ska. Ska, ska, ska.
The thing is, if you look at where he grew up, it's not hard to see how Bolt would have burnt off those carbs.
Not everybody. You can kind of see why someone like Usain Bolt has got such great muscle definition, because if you're having to do this at least once or even twice a week, you're going to be hench, you're going to be built. Thus, Jamaicans as well, actually. If you think about it, the grand scheme of things, they're becoming fit without even thinking about it.
You can move our butterfly.
Bolt grew up here in Trelawney in the north of the island. Like so many young Jamaicans, he would walk to school, run errands for his family, and play football, just like any regular kid. But if you do it in Trelawney, you do it uphill and down.
Everything's organic, so none of that.
If there's one man who should know a thing or two about the environment Bolt grew up in, it's Usain's dad, Wellesley. Your son, he's extraordinary. What he's done for athletics in this country is fantastic. Why do you think in the last 2-3 years, Jamaica have dominated sprinting? Because we could look at Asafa Powell, you can look at other athletes. What is it here? What are you guys doing, man? What are you feeding these people?
But really, You see, Jamaicans, we don't eat a lot of fertilizer food and a lot of spray goes and food in other country. It don't happen here. We eat a lot of yam, normal food that we grow, yam, banana, cocoa, and those things.
And it's all organic food.
Huh? Organic. Mm. And a lot of these are from the hilly terrain. You know, my son, you don't walk miles to school.
Mm. So you're already getting fit before you even know it?
Before you even know it.
Yeah.
So therefore, I think that is one of our causes student them here to run so fast, the athletes. Have a lot, well, this year they have some great sprinters coming up.
I called by Bolt's primary school to learn a bit more about his life growing up. Apparently, as a young boy, he loved playing football.
Come here, go, shoot, shoot!
Many of these children at his old school don't wear shoes to run or play.
Oh, look at the skills, look at the skills!
There's a thought that this might allow the foot muscles to develop more strength. But more than that, sport is a vehicle for many people all over Jamaica to seek a brighter future.
I mean, since I've been here, I mean, kids are just outside, just active all the time. And I think football's very similar to athletics in the sense that for a lot of kids, it's a way to leave poverty, and most of these children here see themselves as the next Didier Drogba, where they see themselves as the next kind of Cristiano Ronaldo. And I think if athletics does just that, and having someone like Usain Bolt being from around here, I think it's a definite inspiration for a lot of them.
Ready?
Yeah.
They may not have the most amazing facilities, but that doesn't seem to matter. Kids this age need someone to look up to, someone who's fought their way out of whatever conditions they grew up in and made it to the big time.
Have you met Usain Bolt before, any of you guys?
Yes, sir.
Really, what's he like? What's he like?
Thick, tall, trapping.
To say Usain Bolt is something of a role model at his old school is probably the understatement of the year.
Can I run? Well, I can run, but not fast. You want to race me? Okay, I'll give you a deal. I'll give you a deal. If you teach me this Usain Bolt dance,
me.
If you guys teach me all together, I'll race you. So leg this way, yeah? Like that. Yeah? Like that. Okay, so we're doing the left one. We're doing the left one. And with this one as well. And then this one again. And then that one again. Winding and grinding. What? You're cheating, man. Hey, you're cheating. You can't do that.
Trelawney is picture postcard Caribbean. Its beaches welcome visitors from around the world. But it wasn't so long ago that its shores were attracting a more sinister trade.
Here at Falmouth Bay, many, many years ago, on a clear day, you could see up to 30 ships bringing slaves in from Africa to work on the plantations. Now that's very hard to believe considering these lovely views, but it's an integral part to Jamaica's history.
These days, the darker moments of Jamaican history are a good draw for the tourist industry. Walking around this place, you get an incredible sense of the wealth this island delivered to the British Empire, but also the human cost. At the end of the 18th century, this whole area was littered with plantations, making this stuff, sugar. Jamaica was the largest producer of sugar at that time. Plantation life was cruel. Slaves as young as five were forced to do back-breaking work from dawn till dusk. Families were split up, and slaves were beaten if they didn't work hard enough. My blood runs cold. It's little wonder that many try to escape, running for their lives. If they were caught, they would be punished by being whipped or having their toes cut so they didn't run away again. But many did manage to escape to freedom. Jamaica had more runaways than anywhere else in the world. And some say that it's this determination and toughness of the African slaves that lives on in Jamaican sprinters today.
No, you don't peel it like that.
How'd you peel it?
Let me show you. You hold it like this. Uh-huh. You take your time and peel it.
So, it could be the African heritage, the hill running, and the yams like these that help Jamaicans run so fast. But surely there must be something more scientific to it than that. Well, there can be one clue to that, sizzling away just next door.
This is your special recipe. Yeah.
Jamaica is known all over the world for its jerk chicken. The meat is marinated in a variety of secret ingredients, including one of the hottest spices going, the Scotch bonnet pepper.
Let's grab some of the zinc and put it on top.
It's then cooked over a wood fire.
Jerk away.
Seeing all this chicken meat reminds me that I've still got more work to do, to find a reason why Jamaican muscles power them to such speeds. I've heard there's a large number of Jamaicans that have something called the fast twitch muscle, something that gives them a greater explosive ability to get off the blocks fast. Professor Errol Morrison is a scientist at Kingston's University of Technology. His research points to a rich gene pool in Jamaica that is producing fast runners.
In the Jamaican group that we have studied so far, the genes are pretty homogeneous. By that I mean it's pretty similar, as opposed to when you look at the runners from the United States. Those very elite runners, the best runners, their genetic makeup is slightly different, it's special, and different from the rest of the community from which they spring. So those are special groups. But in Jamaica, it's all pretty much the same. So there are many more potential Usain Bolts, Asafa Powells, Shelly Ann Fraser's run, many. So Jamaica will rule for a long time to come.
I like this. Not that you're biased.
Not biased at all.
Not that you're biased.
But just having good genes doesn't mean you're going to break a world record. Professor Morrison has also looked into the technique of Jamaican sprinters. So, do I have what it takes?
What do you think?
You saw that symmetry?
Yeah.
You know, that ease. It doesn't come that easily for many others, you know.
Are you serious?
But there's a natural fluidity of style, as we would say. You know, the way in which you have that symmetry. And you have the knee lift without making any effort. You can see that. You know, and I think those are some of the makings, the early makings of a sprinter.
So it seems I've got the physique of a sprinter, but I've also heard about something called the speed gene. So I've come here to the University of the West Indies to find out. Have you tested some Olympians?
Yes.
And do they all possess the speed
they
gene?
They all possess the speed gene.
Wow.
The gene. Food.
Professor Rachel Irvin works at the same university where Usain Bolt trains.
Can you test me for the speed gene?
Well, I need you to test yourself.
She's discovered that the fast twitch muscle can be produced by high levels of something called the strong 57RR variant of the alpha actinin.
Smoothly.
To the other side?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Luckily, it's also called a speed gene, and there's a simple test to see if I've got it. It's present in about 75% of the population.
Oh, here we go. Andy's saliva sample.
Now, obviously, these people don't go on to be Olympic champions, so Professor Irvin has another test up her sleeve.
I'll also test you for a neurotransmitter.
What's a neurotransmitter?
Serotonin, uh-huh. To find out if you're strong enough to win
a
gold medal, if you're somebody like Usain Bolt.
Now, what would those serotonin levels actually indicate? What do they mean?
It determines mental toughness. If your level is low, you tend to be a quitter. If the level is high and you have a special gene, you tend to be very dominant, aggressive, determined. So you're able to win under almost any condition. You close out everything else.
Interesting. So that could possibly...
That gives you the edge.
Be what gives the Olympic champions the edge over everyone else?
Everyone else.
A lot of what I've heard here rings true. There's a little bit of all these theories in many Jamaicans, especially Usain Bolt. It's time to put all this to the man himself.
I'm right, got a microphone, that's all.
Thanks for meeting us, man. This is an absolute pleasure.
I've
been in Jamaica for a few days now, and there is some raw energy here, man. People here are lively. And I also see that when you guys are on the track, you especially and other athletes. Now, what is it? Some people call it arrogance. Is it arrogance or is it confidence?
It's confidence. We're very confident people. We love winning, so we work hard because we're a very proud race, so... Me, it's just, we're just confident in what we do, always.
Anyway, going Caron, boots.
And I went back to your old school and your old primary school, and a lot of the children there were completely inspired by you. They want to emulate you. Some of them not just want to be like you, they want to beat you. I mean, what is that in Jamaicans right here? Why do people, I mean, you guys aim high.
Yeah, definitely. I've seen it from a younger age. A lot of kids always tell me they're going to be like me. Even 5 years old, kids see me and say, I'm going to beat you one day. And it's all fun because they really want to be a champion and they really want to. That's a good thing for us because you drive hard and you aim high, so it's always good.
I met Miss Thorpe, who's your old secondary school teacher. How much of an influence in your life has she been into where you are now?
For me, she's like a second mom.
So therefore, they look somewhere else to see if they could get the amount of people that they needed to work in the sugar industry.
While I was in high school, she looked out for me fully. Anything I wanted, she made sure I was always in class. She was always like, on me in school, make sure everything is okay, always focused and ready. So she played a very big part for me.
Okay, that final question. As a nation, why are you going so fast?
Well, I think, as I said, we're a proud race and we want to be the best in whatever we do, but you saw champs, they work so hard to be the best at champs. It means so much to them because when I was growing up, to win champs gold medals is like winning a world championship gold medals. So many talent comes up. you just keep getting more and more talent because you work so hard to be the best.
I guess the scary thing for me now is that it's not just you. There's plenty more out there that's going to take over the world. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's the one.
There's going to be a lot of talent coming up. I've been telling a lot of them that. Yeah, you're going to be good, but I keep trying to get in their mind from now and say, you're not going to get me. Trying to play on their mind because... The
watch out, man. One day you never know. Yeah. All right, respect what you said. Thank you very much.
No problem,
appreciate
no
it. Back at William Nibb, we're up at the crack of dawn and loading up for the 4-day trip to Kingston. Having spent time with the great man himself, it's all the more poignant to see today's generation of track and field hopefuls from his old school getting ready for their big moment in the spotlight.
You have a great heritage in terms of track and field, not just of the school itself, but for the entire parish. So you have some amount of weight on your shoulders. You can't just go to Kingston to participate. You have to go to Kingston to compete and to compete fiercely. All right, guys, have a good time. Don't be scared, do well.
Water Champs is all about the sport, of course, but it's also much more than that. It's a glimpse into another life away from home, a chance to prove they can achieve something.
Do you think then that Champs is training you guys for the next level?
Yeah, absolutely. And exposing us to the world. Yeah. Because remember when you're out there in the final, the world is watching you. Mm. Okay, as what you said. So yeah, they're inspiring us a lot.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Now, do you guys one day see yourselves in the Olympics?
Well, that's my dream. final, not only in the Olympic. At the gold standard.
Really? The Diamond Leagues and all that kind of stuff? Standing there with Jamaica.
Jamaica, you know what I mean? Lightning strike twice, in the same place. You are upset the question, you miss the race.
But I know your fault that it happened so fast. Unless you're interested in that, who'll come last. The dream of competing at the Olympics is nurtured at schools in Jamaica, and it lasts a lifetime. Just look at these kids' faces. You can see they are serious about making it. But tonight is the start of something big. And for Jamaicans, it doesn't really get bigger than success on the track. What one man achieved in 9.58 seconds has the real potential to change these kids' lives. He's made it, and his story, how he got to where he is today, is in many ways the story for all Jamaicans. And it's pretty sure to be inspiring generations of champs to come. They've got something here. It's Jamaica, man.
You know, we came to Jamaica to find out what it is that makes these guys run so fast. Well, it's a whole heap of things, from the speed gene to food, to the fact that they're the descendants of former slaves. Well, if I'm honest, I think it's a mixture of all of those things. But if Champs is anything to go by, they have a lot more waiting in stock. All I can say is, the world better watch out. Hello, Dr. Irving. Hiya, it's Andy. Yeah, I'm good. All right, well, basically, I want to know whether you've got the conclusion to your speed gene experiment. I have got the speed gene. All right, cool. That's good to know, thank you. All right, bye-bye. I got the speed gene. I kind of already knew that, because I'm just fast.
Jamaicans are proud of him. Now he wears a marvellous crown. Usain Bolt, prince of the track, never. Back.
Anyway, going carron, boat. Boat sell fast and boat sell fit. Him now pull a swing and physically fit. Every race him when he come first meet. Him start out young now, first meet.
Anyway, going carron, boat.
Everybody rate him as the world best. Lightning Bolt, him are the fittest. Me not tell no line deserve me respect for.
Anyway, going carron.
Yeah, man. How much do they like Usain Bolt here? He's such an inspiration to these kids.